the Pennzoil Truck Series heads to Hampton, Georgia, to the Atlanta Motor Speedway for the running of the Pepsi 250. It is our ninth race of the 28-race season. Keith Stevens in the 17 has the pole for tonight's race, to his outsized Tim Randolph in the 42. Then third, second in points, Oliver Galway. He wants to lead a lap early on to get 5 points. If he does, he would take over the points lead. He's only 1 point behind our points there coming into the race. In fourth is Laura Delano, the only driver with multiple victories this season, looking for a third victory. And running out the top five is Riley Spurley too. Then sixth, we have Nathan Stapleton. Seventh place, we have Marcus Sachi. Eighth is Colton Yeo. In ninth, we have Cynthia Bright, with Mathis Wells rounding out the top 10. The rest of the field, there's Koluji. He is our points leader by 1 point coming into this race. He'll start in the inside lane 11th. Who's outside in 12th, Nathan Norman in the 20. Then we have Rusty Shackelford with Danny Lloyd, along with Simon Bloomfield and Sebastian Cucullon. Then there's Danny Bright and Kashawn Richardson, along with Julius Anderson and Jack Cannaramo. Then there's Griffin Lynn and Anthony Hernandez, along with Jonathan Raines and Marshall Burrow. Then we have William Seaman and Max Rossi. Behind them, it's Ray Sir and Trey Rainey. Then we have Mark Silas Jr. and Walker Davis, along with Diego Yepez and Jake Galloway. And starting 33rd is the number 33 of Joe Ward. So there's our 33 trucks for the Pepsi 250 here at Atlanta. Let's go on trackside and fire these engines up.
Drivers, start your engines!
And the 33 Pennzoil Truck Series engines come to life here in Hotlanta as we get ready to do battle around the 1.5 mile Atlanta Motor Speedway in Hampton, Georgia. It'll be 25 laps around this 1.5 mile oval with Keith Stevens on the pole, Tim Rout to his outside, watch for third place Oliver Galloway, because he wants to make a move early on this first lap to get that first lap lead and get 5 bonus points. Because if Koji doesn't get 5 points, they are so close together that any little margin could determine who takes the points lead after race number 9 of the season. Galloway second in points, starts third. Luigi first in points, starts 11th. Pace struck in, under lights, racing at Atlanta, underway! Oliver Galloway did it. 3 wide backstretch. He leads the lap, 5 points for him. Now Koluji, though, he's on the inside. If he can get up at the right time, he can get this lap lead and get 5 bonus points. Spurley takes the lead in the A7. Behind in second comes Marcus Sachi. He moves up. Here comes Cynthia Bright to the bottom of the 6th. That's for a second down the backstretch, side by side. Spurley will get down line. He should be able to lead lap number 2. And Cynthia Bright got a good run through 3 and 4. She got to the back of the A7. Now she moves up with Spurley Tube. Gives the bomb to 24, Koluji. He's looking for 5 points. He came in as the points are only 1 point ahead of Oliver Galloway. Oliver Galloway getting 5 bonus points there. Luigi wants his lap lead badly. He clears first, but can't bring Simon Bloomfield with him. No 19's gonna break low, so now Luigi gonna be in the outside 3 and 4. Jack came around pushing that 92 down the back, got him a little sideways. Bloomfield through 3 and 4. He'll clear Koluigi. Came around with a second. Here comes Griffin in the 54 truck, and 3 wide further back. Simon Bloomfield leads the lap. Cameron with inside lane. Griffin in behind. Marshall Bell to 34 coming forward. Off to turn number 1. Cameron clears and leads. Now he moves up, gives the bomb to Griffin Lynn down the backstretch. Marshall Burrow does it look 3 wide to 34. Behind Oliver Galloway trying to shoot to the middle on Marcus Sachi, but I think he thought better of it. They'll file for about 10 rows. 3 wide for a couple rows further back in the field. Griffin Lynn gonna lead the lap. Burrows to the inside of the 34. They get side by side now 3 wide. That was close into the wall. That was Jack Cameron who nailed the wall though, but kept it going straight. And all 33 trucks still left running at this point in this lead pack. Burrow moves up. In front of Griffin Lynn, gives the bomb to the 51 of Mathis Wells. Racer as well in the bomb. That's 2 Pennzoil Truck Series champions. Coming through in the bomb lane. Wells leads Racer. They're going to come off the corner. They're going to be 1-2 with 20 laps of racing to go here at Atlanta. 20 laps left. Wells leads lap 5. Racer inside lane. Mark Savage Jr. forced 3 wide middle as down low Jake Galloway makes the move. Here comes 33rd starter Joe Ward. Started last in this race. We're only 5.5 laps into it. He's bound for the lead now. He could go 3 wide for the race lead to turn 3. He is going 3 wide. The driver that started 33rd here tonight, Joe Ward, comes off turn four. He's going to lead lap number six of the Pepsi 250. Took him six laps to go from last to first. But now inside the Indiglia Pennzoil, three truck. He'll take it. Another Pennzoil Truck Series champion. Trey Rain wants his shot to lead. Jonathan Rain's the 41. Here comes William Seaman. Rainey tries to shoot the middle lane. I think he's still trying to shoot it, but I think Rain's is down there enough to where the 18 thought better of it. Rain's inside, he'll grab second away. Yeah, Pezzo leading to the three. He's gonna try and lead his first lap of the race. It looks like he's gonna. Seaman a good run down the front stretch as Walker Davis behind pushing. Let's see if the 75 can get beneath the three or not. A three wide for third, closing the other 98 down low. You got a good run through one and two. That truck really rotated the bottom lane well. Yo's now looking for the lead down the back stretch. Seaman moves up Daytona winner. Here comes Colton Yo inside the 98 truck to turn number three. And now, Rusty Shackelford breaks out of line for third. Kukulon there in the two. Tim Randolph. Here comes Keith Stevens. He's starting on pole. He's coming back to the front. So he went from first back to worst. And now in eight laps, back up inside the front five. So it took eight laps to go from first back to 33rd. Back up the lead. So watch for that later on. Could possibly determine who has a chance, as some trucks did get to the wall, and Sacha got down to the apron trying to avoid it. They keep it going for now without a crash. However, this has separated the pack a little bit, as now about 10, 15 trucks are back here, stuck, including our front 2 points. And then Cynthia Bright's kind of between these two packs, but up in front, Colton Yo leads in the 98. Tim Round coming through the 42, he'll try and take the lead away to turn one. Pete Stevens, the 17, start on pole, up to second. Ray Rain, the 18, has found to be back down line. Now that's good for these front drivers. Look at Cynthia Bright, though, in that draft. Even though she has no one around her, then being three wide, the back of this field really helping her. She's getting a toe off the pack. She's going to get right up onto it. And now for these drivers, they have to know, stay single file. If they're single filed out, that's all right. That's going to be good. They're going to catch faster. Ryan Spurgeon makes the move on his teammate, Kashawn Richardson. To lead that front pack, or to lead that second pack up to the front pack, which is being led by Tim Randolph in the 42. Cynthia Bryce joined the field. Riley Sparrowtube in that draft, trying to gain. We'll see the speeds for Cynthia Bryce down the backstretch. 191 for these drivers back here, 191 as well. We'll have to see though the lap time compared to these drivers up towards the front, because right now they've kind of got double filed out. They're not as crazy as they were. However, that could change. Siemens lap, a 28.895. For these drivers, a 28.4, 28.5. So they are reeling in the front pack. They will have a shot. And that could save all 33 trucks who still have a shot. But up at the front, Randolph has done a great job. He could rack up the most laps led here tonight. He's just held off the field for a few laps. Keith Stevens, the pulsar, has been content running in the second position, not trying to pass that 42 of Randolph. And now his teammate, Stevens' teammate, comes low, and the 17 jumped down front of Lynn. He wants DGR to be 1-2 at the front. That's exactly what he did. He waited for his teammate to get low, jumped down from his teammate, and now they're leading. But the 54 is going to get to the inside off turn two. And look at the single file for the 21, the 87. They pulled away from the rest of the field. They have now caught this lead pack, and they have a shot. Lynn to the lead through three and four. Down low tight for the 13. Mark Silas Jr., but he's going to make it work off turn four. We're basically halfway done. 13 laps down in a 25-lap race. Griffin Lynn leads. Jonathan Rains inside the 41. Three wide. Lloyd middle lane. And now this field gets a little antsy towards the front. They're 3x3 in the pack. Silas Jr. looking low down the backstretch, trying to get to Griffin Lynn, the 54. The rest of the field is catching up, you know, here and there. Silas Jr. getting a clear for a second. Jonathan Rains, the 41, through the third. Walker Davis' pusher, Cynthia Bright. Kukulon coming. Long Trey Rain, the 18th down low. Anthony has got a good run to the pack. Made an aggressive move, 3 wide down low. He's almost into the grass making that move. Walker Davis clear through third. Cynthia Bright up fourth in the six. Kukulon, the two, also up here. Trey Rainey, Anthony Nez is coming forward inside the front 10. 21 truck on the inside, moving forward. Nathan Warren behind him in the 20. Sparrowtube has caught up. Kukulon in the pack. Nathan Stapleton is caught up. Randolph, top to bottom, get down from Riley Sparrowtube. But up at the front, they cannot run Griffin Lynn down that 54, doing a great job right now at the front of the field. See Cynthia Bright trying the six to get to that 13, gives Silas Jr. a little bump forward. We have 10 laps to go here in Atlanta. Silas Jr. run down the backstretch, makes the move down low on Griffin Lynn. He gets beneath it. Now where's the six of Cynthia Bright go? She goes low. Silas Jr. flies around Lynn like he was standing still. Mark Silas Jr. leads. Cynthia Bright through the second. Kukulon for third in the two. Now sees it right for the lead. Anthony Nunez splits three wide middle lane, puts Griffin Lynn up top to 54. Walker Davis got the wall, spread the feet out a little there. Bright to clear and lead. Now Sebastian Kukulainen looks low down the back stretch. He has a good run to that six. Can't get down there. Oh, close, he does. Side by side. Kukulainen down low, Bright up top. With Danny Lloyd to help the two truck. Lloyd gonna push, or excuse me, Danny Bright gonna push the two by Cynthia Bright. Points there, force three wide middle. Nathan Simpson makes a move on Cole DeLuigi. Danny Bright through the lead. Tim ran off to second. Orman, Mark Zales Jr. down low. Oh, Nathan Stapleton. Yepez, Ward, three wide. Orman inside the 20. They take it through three and four. Orman to lead the Pepsi 250 here in Atlanta. Mark Zales Jr. at the run. He'll take it to the inside the 13 truck. Two more to the wall. But so far, we have not had an incident because of it. Mark Zales Jr. back up front in Atlanta. Stapleton looks for the lead now. Here comes Yepez, the three. And Oliver Galloway second in points. He was 1 point behind our points there. Luigi currently seated back in the 33rd position. Stapleton flies around to get clear. Joel Ward a good run the bottom lane. Remember, he started 33rd. William Seaman, Daytona winner. Riley Sproul to Griffin Lynn. Rusty Shackelford coming forward. They all have six laps to get to the front and have a shot. Stapleton tried to block down low. Joel Ward kept that from happening. The 33 gets down there. We have limited the three wide for now. We just have a few rows of three wide further back in the field. Up front, double file for the most part. Joe Ward inside will get by Nathan Stapleton through three and four. William Seaman pushing forward. Riley Sproul to Griffin Lynn. Rusty Shackelford down low. Here comes Mathis Wells and Cole DeLuigi, two champions. Five to go. Yellow would end it. Seaman knows that he wants the lead now. Three wide, Lynn force middle lane, the 54 truck. Seaman to the lead in the 75. Sproul now looks low. But is this too early, or will they get a yellow flag to help them out? Rusty Shackelford there. Lynn trying to get down front. Mathis Wells. Luigi shuffled middle lane by Mercer Burrow. Riley Sproul comes off turn four. Four laps of racing to go, and three wide further back of the pack. Seaman leads at the start finish line. Contact to the outside wall so far, keeping it straight. Sproul to Seaman still side by side. No one gained the advantage quite yet. Sproul finally does, I believe he's going to move up though. Give him the bottom to Rusty Shackelford. He's going to look three wide, come to three to go. Three wide for the top spot. Rusty Shackelford powers around. Seaman and Sproul to the lead. Burrow up to second to 34. Now looks for the lead himself. Side by side, three to go in Atlanta. And three wide in the pack. And can they make it? They're four wide. Oh, that might be it. That might be it. Shoving. Contact. Around they go. Stevens, our pole sitter. Who wins the race back? Side by side, it's Kashawn Richardson out in front. Can the 25 racer get there? He will not. Kashawn Richardson powers off turn four, coming to two to go, and the yellow flag, and in all likelihood, a win in Atlanta for the A truck and Kashawn Richardson. Who made it through? Where the 24 and the 27 come out of it? Oliver Galloway, 17th. Cole DeLuigi involved. The 24 back here, 30th. 32nd for Cole DeLuigi. He was involved in the crash. Even though it doesn't look like he has much damage, he had to probably stop. He was on the outside lane when it all happened. Oliver Galloway, in all likelihood, will be our points leader after this race here tonight. For Kashawn Richardson, he'll win a Pennzoil Truck Series race. He already has two Target Series victories. He'll add a Pennzoil Truck Series win to his resume. He's going to win the Pepsi 250 at the Atlanta Motor Speedway here in Hampton, Georgia. As the field comes around to the white flag, we will stay for this final lap as Kashawn Richardson will have to just coast around 1.5 miles under the yellow flag at 60 miles an hour pace speed. Racer going to end up second. Marsha Burrow, Colton Yeo, and Rusty Shackelford will be the front five. As you mentioned, the points going to take a big swing here as Oliver Galloway made his way through the crash up to 17th, and Cole DeLuigi was back near the crash, had to slow down. He'll end up 32nd here in tonight's race. So for Cole DeLuigi, he will lose the points lead, definitely, after he's had a string of few bad races after starting the season so strong. Lately, it's just not been great for the 24. It's been feast or famine this season so far. Kashawn Richardson, though, looking to add his name into possible candidates to try and make the chase and battle for the championship. Racer, last season's champion, will get second. That'll propel him up in the points as he's had a hit or miss season as well, just like his teammate Cole Luigi. Served one earlier in the season. He was denied his second victory though this season as he got tight down the bottom of 3 and 4 and couldn't get a run to get to the 8 of Koshan Richardson in time. So 4 wide coming off turn 2 with 2.5 to go. Ends the race early because Koshan Richardson doesn't care about it. And it's going to be a win in the Pennzoil Truck Series for him as he coasts through 3 and 4. He can see the checkered flag now as he comes out onto the main straightaway. Koshan Richardson, checkered flag in the air. Pennzoil Truck Series win here at Atlanta for truck number 8. Richardson takes the checkered flag and wins the Pepsi 250 at the Larimore Speedway. And as the field comes across Alvergao inside the top 20, Cole Luigi back in 30 seconds. Let's see the caution which ends the race. 4 wide, Keith Stevens, our Pulsar, one of them involved. This 4 wide was never going to work. 2 DGR trucks in the middle of it, Griffin Lynn, Keith Stevens, and Simon Bloomfield, William Stephen, along with Mathis Wells. Riley Spiritu then gets into it as he backs up the outside. 17.92 make contact up the racetrack. Wells trying to stay off the A7. If maybe they had a few more seconds, they would have been all right, but the 17 down front of the field. Anthony Hernandez gets clipped right there. There's Cynthia Bright going for a spin. Jack Karen Ramo. Stapleton, one of the only ones to escape. There's Koluji spin towards the inside wall, and there's where Oliver Galloway gets through right there. Trucks wound up on the inside. Wrecking up ahead, wrecking everywhere. Caution flag ends the race 2 laps early. Yeah, right there, Mathis Wells was so close to clearing that A7. If he possibly would have, they maybe would have avoided incident and the 17 would just hit the 51 up into line. But what it all turned out to be was they all wrecked everywhere. See, they were still crashing in 3, in the engine 3. As we look at it, and you'll see some of the trucks dive down towards the inside right here. As Cole Luigi gets involved, he had slowed down and then got ran over from behind Delano. One last race. 88, the 51. A lot of trucks. There's Griffin and Anthony Hernandez, who ended up in a heap. Enters the turn 3, wondering how that happened. Just see the 54 down to the 21. Oh, he spun the 21 out. And I think the 21 just kind of slid and took out the 54 with them. There's Oliver Galloway getting through it. Looking at this, it just looks like they kind of slid into it. You'll see right here as Griffin tries to avoid it, gets hit down into the 21. Who then spins, and the 54 kind of just gets stuck behind him. Nowhere to go, and I mean, he followed him all the way through, and right there, trying to gas it, get by, hits the 21. And that's what cost them a ton of their spots. But it ends up with Koshan Richardson in victory lane as he wins the Pepsi 250. Let's go see the finishing results. Here's how they finished at the end of the Pepsi 250 at the Atlanta Motor Speedway. 1 caution flag for 2 laps and 17 lead changes among 16 different drivers. Koshan Richardson leads the final 3 laps, 2 of which under yellow, to get to victory lane here today. Ray Searns in 2nd with that great day moves up to 2nd in points. Marshall Burrell is 3rd, Colton Yeo 4th, Rusty Shackelford in 5th. Then Simon Bloomfield 6th, Joe Ward 7th, Sebastian Kukulon 8th, Nathan Stapleton 9th, and Cynthia Bright rounds at the top 10. Looking at the top 20, Nathan Norman, 16th place day for him. He ends up 3rd in points now. Oliver Galloway, 17th with the lap led, moves him up into the points lead for the 2017. Remember, they won at Las Vegas earlier in the season. Looking down at the rest, Keith Stevens from the pole, never got to lead a lap here today, ends up 23rd after being involved in the final caution. Griffin Lynn led the most laps. It's crazy to say that in 25 laps, the most laps led was 4, but sure enough, that's how it was for Griffin Lynn. Led 4 laps, he gets 5 extra bonus points for that. Ends up 28th, though, involved in the big crash there at the end. And for Cole Luigi, he goes from the points lead to 4th with a 32nd place finish. However, all 33 trucks finish the race on the lead lap and running. And here are the Pennzoil Truck Series point standings. As Oliver Galloway, with his mediocre day here today, it's good enough to take over the points lead by 34 for Ray Serhunu, moves up to 2nd. So GMS still keeping themselves within the hunt with the 25 and the 24, both up inside the front 5. Orman's up to 3rd, Luigi falls to 4th, but still within range of that points lead. And Colton Yeo up inside the top 5. He's had a very quiet and consistent season so far. Nathan Stapleton 6th, William Seaman Daytona winner is 7th, Joe Ward in 8th, Danny Lloyd in 9th, and Marcus Sacchi rounds up the top 10. Look at the top 20, and right here you can see only one winner from 11th to 20th in points. It means Walker Davis has a wild card spot. The other one goes to Max Rossi, who is 2 points outside the top 10, and it is close within, I would say, about eighth down. Eighth place Joe Ward is only, right now, 9 points ahead of 10th place. And then you look down, Max Rossi is only 2 points behind 10th. Marshall Burrell is only 2 points back of Max Rossi, so 4 points back. Walker Davis is 6 points back at 10th. Tim Ralph is 11 points back at 10th. So from 8th to 14th, you can cover them with a blanket right now of points. One race could change the swing of how that goes. You'll see some other winners down here below the top 20 in points, one of them being Lord Alano, who got back inside the top 20 with her win. Now, once again, a bad finish down below the top 20. She needs to be top 20. With those two victories, I can almost guarantee that she's going to be in the running for a wild card. However, she needs three more positions and points if she wants to have a shot at the wild card, because Sean Merchant with that win moves up to 24th in the point standings, and Jonathan Rain still mired down in 27th. Yepez is still looking for his first top 10 of the season. He's mired down 33rd in the point standings, but we'll see. We're only 9 races in. We still have a lot to be determined. Someone could go out and win 2 or 3 straight, and they could be in the hunt for bound for a championship, bound for a chase spot. So we look ahead, 9 races down. Our 10th race will head to northeastern Pennsylvania. We head to the Tricky Triangle Lawn Pond, Pennsylvania. It's the Pocono Raceway for the Pennsylvania Lottery 200. I will see you guys then.